okay, I think with 60% of the budget potentially going on staff costs, and appreciably there's a start-up cost to this and efficiencies will be made, but is there any intention to levy some charges to the businesses that are accessing this service?
Established a task four recommendations were made by the committee, which went to the command authority in June, and they were all unanimously supported and welcomed. And since June, I think it's very fair to say that profile air quality has continued to grow across the city region, and indeed nationally. The climate earth core case will be apparent, which has in turn mandated, or has resulted in certain local authorities being mandated to take further action to deal with their air quality problems, Liverpool and Sefton, as obvious locally. So it's still a very, very live issue for us. The table here, I'm sorry, this is quite small, but this is a reproduction of the report that was put forward by the committee last year, or sorry, earlier in the summer. And there were a number of recommendations made. I'm not going to read through these at all, you need to. I just want to highlight a couple. Very much the recommendations were about raising the profile of poor air quality, using the combined authorities, championing role, the mayor's status, the mayor's convening powers, to be able to support you as local authorities to raise the whole profile of air quality. So as an example, Europe Action on the Environment next year is an initiative that's being promoted by Gideon Bentover, who's the mayor's advisor on environmental quality. The Climate Authority is actively supporting that, and air quality is one of the top eight thematic areas that form part of that year of action. So there's an example of how the profile and activities and promotions will be taken forward at a local level. The mayor talked earlier about transforming cities as an important funding source that has a specific aim of improving air quality. It's about sustainable transport, it's about connectivity, but it's also about reducing emissions from transport. Focus on walking, cycling, public transports. Since this report was considered by the Provider Authority, the amount of money we've lost has grown, as Metro Mayor said. Before we had 134, we got an additional 38 million in the budget, which was very good news. So we have £170 million to be allocated over the next 4 years, a nice situation to be in. And equally, the final recommendations were about mainstreaming air quality, making sure that air quality features in our spatial strategy development. And authority in the local industrial strategy that Councillor Davis talked about a few moments ago. And quite importantly, quite recently, about raising and support, or raising the profile across the city region, but also supporting local authorities locally and other partners through the establishment of a task force, a command authority, local city region task force on air quality. That was a recommendation by the committee, and it was agreed by the combined authority at its last meeting. We're just in the process now of working in terms of reference and membership. That will be a high priority, high profile officer and member group with external bodies as well. Just very quickly to come back to that first point, I think this is really the next step for the committee. One of the actions from the Overview and Scrutiny Committee was that we needed to have a Liverpool City Region Air Quality Action Plan to take forward these actions and to articulate them in a simpler format and take forward specific pieces of work. That was supported, and it was agreed that this committee would see that, would scrutinise that piece of work, that air quality action plan, before it goes on to the combined authority, so it's free scrutiny of that process. That was also agreed by the combined authority. So just to sum up, you can see there are a number of actions that are being implemented from the early recommendations. The task force that was agreed that the combined authority is being established, that will help to shape our air quality action plan. And we've committed and agreed that our action plan will come back to the Overview and Scrutiny panel, the Overview and Scrutiny Committee, ahead of the Command Authority, aiming for this to be in March of 2019. And I have to say, any questions? There's very much work to come, Chair.
Thank you very much for that, Hugh. I think it's a positive action taken from the Scrutiny Committee, and it's obviously been taken up by the Command Authority as well, so that's reassuring. Is there any questions from members? Councillor Wainwright?
No, a question, more comment. When you see in that format, you see that it's a place to go to, you really do realise that, that we actually are making some sort of difference.
Thank you, Councillor Gashin.
Thanks, sir. Hugh, if you cast your mind back, there's a travel. When we were a transport of our policy, we were the first in the country to set up an environmental committee, which I had the privilege to chair. And lots of these things that's you're envisaging now must already have been worked up, sorted, and they will be historically lying somewhere, because you know, we used to get regular reports on air quality, you know, you used to report, others used to report. So lots of that stuff will already be there. And we can look back historically and also tell the world that we were the first. And now Cllr can find out that we're continuing that.
Just very quickly on that, Chair. It's a fair point, some really pioneering work has been done. I think the potential we've got as a combined authority is to bring all our powers together, which include planning, investment, funding, housing, homelessness, social inclusion, air quality, transport. We can bring all those powers and funds together. And I think that's the real value of doing it through this process.
Thank you, Councillor Murphy.
It is good to see, but it would have been good to see it in the general papers. I think the members of this committee and the members of the board should have information in advance if we get reports to this committee, and also if we graphics as well.
Thank you, Councillor. I think that seems to be a okay thing to do, so make sure that happens in the future. Right, so is there any more questions or comments from the committee? Oh, can I thank you for the report there, and we don't support pause. Thank you. Right. Item number 10 is the Overview and Scrutiny Committee Workshops Task and Finish Group. Can I invite Kirsty Pearce, Super Scrutiny Officer, to take us through the report, please?
So this report sets out proposals around the workshops that we suggested. This report sets out the proposals around the workshops that we suggested we hold. We had the first one of those on housing, and thank you very much to those members of the committee that were able to attend. I hope you found that session helpful. It will be useful to get feedback from people who haven't already on how that session went, so that we can make any improvements and changes that are needed for future sessions. The suggested programme is in the paper that was circulated. There is, however, one change that we would like to make. Unfortunately, due to staff illness, we would like to switch the presentation on the EU funding with the careers funding. So that means the EU presentation would move until January, and we would bring forward the careers presentation to be in December. Apologies for the late change of that. I'm afraid it is entirely due to a member of staff being unfortunately off sick. They will not be back in time for that date in December. We didn't want to cancel that session, however, so our suggestion is that we go ahead with that date, but we use that for the career session instead.
Thank you, Kirsty.
In addition, Chair, we wanted to advise the committee of proposed arrangements to have an opportunity to scrutinise the budget. So we're proposing to put an additional meeting into the diary of colleagues in the room for the 30th of January, which is a Wednesday, usual time at 10:15, and that will allow the Scrutiny Committee the opportunity to influence and comment on the budget before its presentation to the Combined Authority on Friday of that week, which is on the 1st of February. If that could be agreed, Chair, I'm very grateful.
Thank you, Jill. Just before we agree, there are any questions or comments from the members?
Comment on that last one, I think. Can I give my apologies now, or will be off to the temple?
Councillor Marshall.
Thanks, Chair. Yeah, just saying, I know we did get off to quite a slow start with this group through various political changes across the Liverpool City region, but can we just start keeping a record of actually the amount of hours that are being given over by the committee to the various workshops, briefings? They are vitally important. Perhaps as somebody who works full time, I just need to be able to justify lots of my attendance here and away from work. So that would be just really useful, I think, if we could have quarterly or yearly what we've done for the year. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Martin. That's a very important point. Councillor Banks.
Just to say that representatives from the Standard Form, we have to attend.
Any other questions or comments? Councillor Marshall.
Can we just have the change of dates again? again, sorry.
It's the 17th of January, 2019.
It's not the date that's changed, it's the subject matter that members are going to be asked to consider. So the dates and arrangements remain the same. You won't talk about EU Brexit, you'll talk about careers, items, issues.
Thanks for that, So, with what Jill said in mind, can we agree the recommendations that are set out in page 39 of the agenda, please?
Agreed.
And the date of the next meeting, item number 11, because of the item earlier, the date of the next meeting will be the 30th of January 2019 and not the 6th of March 2019. So, with that in mind, colleagues, can I ask members to please note in your diaries the date of the next meeting? The LCR Overview and Scrutiny Committee. Councillor Wayne, right.
Can we clarify? I thought that was just a one-off agenda item on the budget, and not. I'd say the reason that the sink was still there. Thank you very much.
Yeah, just add that to the next meeting, Councillor Wayne, right. Any further comments from the